Now, serotonin goes awry in psychosis in the following way. You've seen in other lectures that the first glutamate neuron, the pyramidal neuron in the orange, talking to the GABA neuron in the purple, talking to a third neuron, which is another pyramidal neuron in the orange, and that little guy is decorated with 5-HT2A receptors. And those 5-HT2A receptors are always excitatory. There's even some pyramidal neuron that's coming out here to the visual cortex. At the bottom, the big thing is actually the prefrontal cortex, but at the bottom you've got the striatum and two dopamine pathways from the VTA, ventral tegmental area, and SN, substantia nigra. And then the yellow stuff comes from the RAFA, which is serotonin. Okay, so that's your baseline. Nothing's wrong yet. So let's go ahead. Let's put a hallucinogen in, psilocybin, mescaline. So it stimulates these receptors, and it causes you to have a mystical experience, a visual hallucination, and maybe a cure from your treatment-resistant depression. One thing they don't tell you, and not shown here, is that 5-HT2A agonists also cause neurite formation, which means it sprouts little connections. And it may not be the hallucinations of psilocybin, which is therapeutic, although some people think you have to have a trip or it won't work. I don't think so. I actually side with the point of view that the hallucinations are a side effect and an epiphenomenon. What really is the reason that these drugs work is to cause neurite formation. But you'll hear more about that in the chapter on mood. Right now, you need to know that indeed psilocybin, mescaline, LSD all can cause too much stimulation of these receptors. Neurite formations are not, and it's going to make you hallucinate. Too much 5-HT2A. You excite glutamate by hallucinogens, and downstream, that orange thing is going to hit that whoop, and it's going to drive it, and now you get more delusions and hallucinations. So this is not a good thing. This is the anatomy of psychosis, driven by too much serotonin at 2A receptors. And it's too much because you took a hallucinogen which overstimulates those receptors. That's why they cause psychosis. This is the pathway. In Parkinson's disease, you also get psychosis from this pathway, but for different reasons. So if you remember your Parkinson's disease, the nigrostriatal pathway dies, and you get Parkinsonism, which is akinesia, rigidity, tremor, the movements of Parkinson's disease. But that's not all. Even though that's very important, did you know you also start to lose your RAFA nucleus? And when you lose it and lose it, to about 50% or more of your serotonin is gone, you make that serotonin on the glutamate neuron very angry. It says, you mess up with my serotonin, I grow you more receptors. So, in a futile kind of attempt to overcome the loss of its serotonin, that glutamate neuron has caused way too much serotonin 2A receptors. And in fact, a paradox ensues. Now you've got too much 5-HT2A receptor stimulation, and it does the same thing as LSD or psilocybin does. It overstimulates downstream, it gives you visual cortex hallucinations, it gives you downstream hallucinations, and you get sort of delusions, hallucinations, not good. This is why people have this in Parkinson's disease. The same thing happens in dementia, but for a little bit different. What's happening in dementia is not so much that the yellow serotonin is gone and that there are too many receptors that grow there, but that you knock out this GABA interneuron with your plaques, your tangles, your strokes, your Lewy bodies, all the things that cause stroke. If you knock those out, you lose your GABA adrenergic inhibition. So the smartest thing would be to give a drug that puts the GABA adrenergic inhibition back, but we don't have those. So what else could you do? Well, if that neuron is in balance between inhibition by GABA and excitation by serotonin, and we've lost our GABA inhibition, how about if we tone down the serotonin 2A excitation? And indeed, if you lose this inhibition, you can now stop the now out of balance, this is now too much because you don't have GABA. You don't need the serotonin stuff in there. So what you do is you have hallucinations due to overexcitation and under inhibition. And now what are you going to do? You're going to block it with a 5-HT2A antagonist, which I'll talk about in the chapter on treatment. Here's just another way of showing the same thing, but this is now on a brain instead of schematically. Here are your three neurons, glutamate, GABA, glutamate, going downstream to your dopamine in blue. Hallucinogen psychosis, you put the hallucinations in 5-HT2A receptors up there, and you get too much dopamine downstream, and that causes you problems. You get too much actually in your visual cortex, you get visual hallucinations. Psychosis and Parkinson's disease, we talked about this already. What happens, you lose your yellow neurons. First of all, you lose your substantia nigra, your blue neuron, you should get Parkinson's disease. Then you lose your yellow neurons, and then you grow too many receptors, and then you end up having downstream dopamine going. Have you noticed a pattern here? Every time I give you a hallucination and a delusion, there's too much dopamine. So whether dopamine just goes up by itself somehow, whether dopamine goes up because you give amphetamine, whether it goes up because you have an upstream glutamate neurodevelopmental problem, or you have a screw up of your serotonin system, it all leads downstream to the same final common pathway. And so finally, psychosis and dementia, it will not surprise you that you knock out these receptors in the cortex with your degenerative illness, you end up having a loss of your GABA inhibition, a relative too much, not because it's too much, but only relative to the fact you've lost GABA, you've still got too much excitation. It's sort of like you lost your brake. So now all of a sudden your accelerator's too much. You gotta take your foot off the accelerator a little bit and block some of those, or else you're going to have psychosis and dementia, and indeed 5-HT2A antagonists work for dementia psychosis.